in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ said, Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, with all thy mind, and with all thy strength. This is the first commandment, and the second is like, namely this, thou shalt love thy neighbour as thyself. There is none other commandment greater than these. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets.
Lord, have mercy upon us. And write all these thy laws in our hearts, we beseech thee.
Let us pray. Lord, we beseech thee, grant thy people grace to withstand the temptations of the world, the flesh, and the devil, and with pure hearts and minds to follow thee, the only God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Galatians. But the scripture has imprisoned all things under the power of Satan, so that what was promised through faith in Jesus Christ might be given to those who live in it. Now before faith came, we were imprisoned and guarded under the law until faith would be revealed. Therefore the law was our disciplinarian,
said that, of course, if I wanted to, I could preach. I could deliver some sort of a homily. And I said, yes, or I might be lazy and just share my memories of this place. So I'm going to be lazy. I hope you'll have plenty of good preaching tomorrow. You don't need more right away. This place for me has been very much a part of my life. I was brought up here, I think, by a school friend's father one afternoon in the 1960s, and I don't remember the chapel much, to my shame, but I do remember the painted church being absolutely blown over and having to go up, I don't know if you're allowed to do it now, but having to go up and touch the trompe l'oeil pilasters. I just simply couldn't believe that they weren't real. And that alone is fixed in my mind. And sort of really, once I came to live in the area in the 1980s, I knew that this was somewhere I had to reacquaint myself with. Alas, I've never worshipped here until today. I was always nicely tied up either at the cathedral or St. Paul's Deptford down the way, so I've never actually worshipped in here. But I came close to it when Charles McCarris conducted the Nelson Mass here. Can you imagine that wonderful, wonderful piece of Haydn, Nelson Mass in Greenwich, with a fabulous choir and orchestra? I was up there somewhere and was simply transfixed, a wonderful coming together of every sort of aesthetic you can imagine. It's absolutely glorious. And we are, aren't we, so blessed to have places like this that speak slightly differently about God to the ways we're often accustomed to. Most of us, for good or ill, find ourselves in Gothic or neo-Gothic places of worship, and they are wonderful in their way. But the confidence, the boldness of classical architecture also moves me very profoundly. And thank you, Mother, for sort of spelling out various elements of it, because sometimes people are a bit snooty and they think it's sort of just pagan or almost Roman architecture. But to see how a building of this transcendent beauty can still embody the essentials of the faith and reflect Holy Scripture so faithfully in its details. And thank heavens the Victorian glass was blown out. What a blessing. We can thank Hermann Göring for that at least, to enable us to see this chapel in all its simple and striking beauty. So our thanks to you, Mother, for hosting us today. We are few, inevitably, at a time like this, but I think we're being recorded even as I speak, and we will no doubt, if that's okay, have a group photograph at the end, so everybody will know that the company of service carries on, and that Christ's religion is very much alive and well here at the Old Royal Naval College. Thank you. So let us pray for the whole state of Christchurch, militant here in earth. Almighty and ever-living God, who by thy holy apostle has taught us to make prayers and supplications, and to give thanks for all, we humbly beseech thee most mercifully to accept our alms and oblations, and to receive these our prayers, which we offer unto thy divine majesty, beseeching thee to inspire continually the universal church with the spirit of truth, unity, and concord, and grant that all they that do confess thy holy name may agree in the truth of thy holy word and live in unity and godly love. We beseech thee also to save and defend all Christian kings, princes, and governors, and especially thy servant Elizabeth our Queen, that under her we may be godly and quietly govern, and grant unto her whole council, and to all that are put in authority under her, that they may truly and impartially minister justice to the punishment of wickedness and vice, and to the maintenance of thy true religion and virtue. Give grace, O Heavenly Father, to all bishops, priests, and deacons, that they may both by their life and doctrine set forth thy true and lively word, and rightly and duly administer thy holy sacraments. And to all thy people give thy heavenly grace, and specially to this congregation here present, that with meek heart and due reverence they may hear and receive thy holy word, truly serving thee in holiness and righteousness all the days of their life. And we most humbly beseech thee of thy goodness, O Lord, to comfort and succour all them who in this transitory life are in trouble, sorrow, need, sickness, or any other affliction. And we also bless thy holy name for all thy servants departed this life in thy faith and fear, beseeching thee to give us grace so to follow their good examples that with them we may be partakers of thy heavenly kingdom. Grant this, O Father, for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate. Amen.
Amen.
And we pray together.
O eternal Lord God, our Creator and our Judge, hear our prayer as we offer to thee our worship and thanksgiving. Keep us mindful of those who have conducted their business on the seas in the defence of this realm, those who have worshipped in this chapel through the centuries, and those who seek now both to follow their faithful example and to spread the glorious news of thy gospel. Preserve us in all our doings, and grant us thy continuous help. We ask this in the name of him whose light we follow, shining as a beacon across the ocean of our life, even Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Ye that do truly and earnestly repent you of your sins, and are in love and charity with your neighbours, and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God, and walking from henceforth in his holy ways, draw near with faith, and take this holy sacrament to your comfort, and make your humble confession to Almighty God. Almighty God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, maker of all things, judge of all men, we acknowledge and bewail our manifold sins and wickedness, which we from time to time most grievously have committed, by thought, word, and deed, against thy divine majesty, provoking most justly thy wrath and indignation against us. We do earnestly repent, and are heartily sorry for these our misdoings. The remembrance of them is grievous unto us, the burden of them is intolerable. Have mercy upon us, most merciful Father, for thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ's sake, forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may ever hereafter serve and please thee in newness of life, to the honour and glory of thy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who of his great mercy hath promised forgiveness of sins, to all them that with hearty repentance and true faith turn unto him, have mercy upon you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you to everlasting life, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Hear what comfortable words our Saviour Christ saith unto all that truly turn to him. Come unto me, all that travail and are heavy laden, and I will refresh you. So God loved the world, that he gave his only begotten Son, to the end that all that believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Mm-hmm.
us bless them.
We lift them up unto thee.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord our God.
It is
very good, right and our bounden duty, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, almighty everlasting God. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of thy glory. Glory be to thee, O Lord most high. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. We do not presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy so much as to gather up the crumbs under thy table, but thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us therefore, gracious Lord, so to eat the flesh of thy dear Son, Jesus Christ, and to drink his blood, that our sinful bodies may be made clean by his blood, and our souls washed through his most precious blood, and that we may evermore dwell in him.
And he
is. Amen. Almighty God, our heavenly Father, who of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there by his one oblation of himself once offered, a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and did institute, and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me. The blood. that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, grant us thy peace. As our Saviour Christ has commanded and taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, in earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Almighty and ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee, for that thou dost vouchsafe to feed us, who have duly received these holy mysteries, with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favour and goodness towards us, and that we are very members incorporate in the mystical body of thy Son, which is the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom, by the merits of the most precious death and passion of thy dear Son. And we most humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship, and all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honour and glory, world without end. Amen. Glory be to God on high, and in earth peace, goodwill towards men. We praise thee, we bless thee, we worship thee, we glorify thee. We give thanks to thee for thy great glory. O Lord God, heavenly King, God the Father Almighty, O Lord, the only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, O Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. Thou that takest away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. Thou that sittest at the right hand of God the Father, have mercy upon us. For thou only art holy, thou only art the Lord, thou peace of God, which passeth all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.